Well, hey everyone, welcome to Manna Church Online, and really thank you for letting us be part of your life today. And look, we'd love to hear your story. We'd love to hear from you. I love stories, and I bet you have a great one. So please let us hear from you. Just go to our website and click the Connect tab. And also, if you would like to give, it's super simple. So also, just go to our website and you can hit the Give tab there, but we really want to hear from you. So this morning, welcome again. We are continuing a video series we began last week by Pastor Robert Morse from Gateway Church in South Lake, Texas, entitled The Blessed Life. And this series is about putting God first in every area of our lives, which includes putting God first in our finances. Now, I know when we talk about money, it's a sensitive thing to talk about. And besides physical intimacy, money is probably the most personal and protected area of our lives, I would think. And believe me, I know you work hard and make sacrifices for your kids, providing a home and saving for college and weddings, and if you have anything left over, saving for retirement. And honestly, it's precisely because it's hard and time-consuming to provide for your family that we need to know what God says, what the Bible says about our finances and how they can be blessed. We want God to bless our marriages. We want God to bless our kids. We want God to bless our businesses, our IRAs, our 401ks, our investments, and all of our income. We need a blessed life. And when you come to the Bible, objectively, and that's how we approach it, and you really just follow the evidence, what it says, no matter where it leads, this is the only conclusion that I think you and I can really come to, and that is our lives are most blessed when we do things God's way rather than the way we think they should be done. And I'll tell you, doing life the way the Bible says to do it will require you to trust God in ways you have never trusted Him before. But the result will be His presence and fruitfulness in our life and this thing called multiplication and increase. But let me say, as we get into this, if you never ever give, it will never diminish God's love for you. Hear that? So giving doesn't make God love you more, but it will release a blessing upon our lives. But know that just like the laws of physics, if you jump off a three-story building, there will be consequences to your actions. And when we do life God's way, the consequences, we're told, is a blessed life. I love that. So in a moment, I want you to hit the pause button, scroll down to the description and click the link below for part two of this series called The Blessed Life from Pastor Morse. Then, when you finish watching this video link, come back, unpause this video, and I'll have some closing remarks. So, let's get started. Okay, go ahead, pause the video, scroll down to the description, watch the video, and I'll see you after. Hey, welcome back. Thanks for coming back. Pastor Robert spoke about the principle of first. What a powerful principle and thing to learn about God. God would never ask us to do what He Himself is unwilling to do. And God demonstrates to us His willingness to live the principle of first out by giving us His best, His first and only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. See, God gave us His best. He gave us His first, His Son, the Lamb of God without sin, in our place to be sacrificed for us who are sinful so that we can live with God. God does this so we can actually fellowship with Him. We can live with God. And when we repent of our sin and believe Jesus died in our place, repentancy is when we say in our hearts, I want to do my life Your way, God. Whatever You say, how I should live, however You say I should live, that's what the way that I want to live my life. In other words, God, Your will be done in my life and not my own. And when we give God our heart, our first, He changes our heart and comes to live inside of us by His Holy Spirit. So I just want to give you an opportunity. If you would like to repent and ask God to come live in you, just pray this prayer. Just say, God, I want to know You. And I want to know what it means to truly turn my life over to you by repenting. In Jesus' name, amen. Now listen, if you really meant that, then I want you to do something. I want you to go to our website and click the Connect tab and let us know you prayed. We would love to chat with you and share more with you about what comes next in your walk with God and what that really means. You can't do this alone. We need each other. We've been isolated too much. And so we want to do life with God, with one another, and together. So listen, let us hear from you. So can't wait to see you next week as Pastor Robert sets up the next week by asking this question: Am I generous? Don't miss it. We'll see you next week. And now I know that this is the good life. Never look back when I traded for a day in my own life. Never look back because I know that you are always with me. I got you. I know you got me. This is the good life. You gave me the good life. I always thought that I'd be fine. And all the things that left me dead inside.